Good evening, doctors. Welcome again. Our today's topic is ED. ED represent here erectile dysfunction. It's erectile dysfunction. Definition is importance. We can say erectile dysfunction is inability to get and keep an erection firm enough for intercourse or sexual activity. What is erection? A hardness or tightness of a penis is known as proper erection. Now, the erectile dysfunction causes most common or more than 80% cases are physical cause. Psychological is nearly 10%, and psychological cause strong response to placebo treatment. So hope this definition is clear. Now, what are the signs and symptoms of erectile dysfunction? There is regular or repeated inability to achieve or maintain erection of sufficient rigidity to accomplish sexual activity. At least 3 months, remember, at least 3 months, not 1 day, not 5 days, not 1 month, but history of 3 months. He is not able to perform his activity or inability of getting proper erection. So these are the signs and symptoms. It includes two categories. I will explain you. A male who never achieved erection in their life, or a second type of male, a male who achieved erection but after a year or 2 years he developed erectile dysfunction. So two different cases. Now let's discuss about the causes. Causes include a patient. Firstly, you have to see carefully drugs. History of drugs like SSRI, antidepressant, selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, beta blockers like propranolol, alpha 2 adrenergic receptor agonists, thiazides like patient on Telma-H, means telmisartan with hydrochlorothiazide, or on Losar-H, alpha reductase inhibitors like finasterides, dutasterides. These are used in prostate reduction. So these medicines causes erectile dysfunction, remember. Now, second most important cause is neurogenic disorders, like diabetic neuropathy is a complication, erectile dysfunction of diabetes, temporal lobe epilepsy, multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's disease. According to the age, as age prolongs, Parkinson's disease enters. Cavernosal disorder, like Peyronie's disease, there is a scar development in a penis, which also cause hyperprolactinemia and prolactinoma. Watch prolactin level. Physiological causes: performance anxiety, stress, mental disorder, or sometimes prostate surgery like TURP. Transurethral resection of prostate causes erectile dysfunction. Aging 4 times more in man aged his 60s than 40s. A old man has more, 4 times more erectile dysfunction as compared to a young male. Sometimes a CRF, means chronic renal failure, is a cause of erectile dysfunction. Lifestyle, a smokers, we found erectile dysfunction in smokers. It promotes the atrial narrowing, or in alcoholic also we see erectile dysfunction. Now let's discuss why this erectile dysfunction happens. What was the mechanism? Penile erection. There is two mechanism which affects the penile erection. First is reflex erection, second is psychological erection. Let's discuss individually. Reflex erection achieved directly through the penile shaft. And psychogenic erection achieved by erotic or emotional stimuli. Okay. This penile shaft erection directly leads to secretion of nitric oxide, relax the smooth muscles. But in both cases, we see intact neural system is required, successful and complete erection required. Adequate levels of testosterone produced by testes and intact pituitary gland are required development of health erectile system. Sometimes CAD, coronary artery diseases due to atherosclerosis. This atherosclerosis restriction of blood flow to the genital penis region. So it also causes erectile dysfunction. So hope it's clear. Now, how to diagnose this erectile function disorder? We have to go for duplex ultrasonography, evaluate the blood flow, venous leak, and signs of atherosclerosis. We can know by the help of this. Scarring or calcification of erectile tissue. Injection prostaglandin induces erection. See vascular dilatation. Vascular dilation here. Measures penile blood pressure. So hope you understand the use of duplex ultrasonography. Now, penile nerve function. Bulbocavernous reflux determines sufficient nerve sensation in the penis. Physician squeezes the glands. Head of penis immediately causes the anus to contract. If the nerve function normal, gloved finger insert the anus. How to do this test? One finger in a insert anus and press the penis shaft. And when there is a contraction in a anus, then it's a test is positive. If the test is negative, means a patient have sensation. And if there is no contraction, then means patient has erectile dysfunction, no nerve sensation. Now, nocturnal penile tumescence, 5 to 6 erections during sleep in rapid eye movement, we see. Another test is penile biothesiometry, electromagnetic vibration to evaluate the sensitivity and nerve function in the glands and shaft of penis. One more cause in a male, when they wake up, they found some erection in a penis. If there is no morning erection when they wake up, that means they have ED. Okay. Now, dynamic infusion cavernometry technique, which fluid pumped into the penis at a non-rate and pressure gives measurement of vascular pressure in corpus cavernosum. During erection, or we can go for cavernosonography or MRI angiography of penis. This will help you to rule out the cause of erectile dysfunction. Now, how to treat this erectile dysfunction? Firstly, treat the cause. Always we are going to treat the cause, or we can use PDE5 inhibitors, prostaglandin E5 inhibitors like sildenafil. Brand name is Viagra, very very famous. Tadalafil, Vardenafil, we can use, or creams combining Alprostadil, permeation enhancer, DDAIP, we can use in erectile dysfunction, or penile injections like papaverine, phentolamine, prostaglandin E1, we can use for erectile dysfunction. Nowadays, penis pumps are get approval or permission for use, may use just prior the sexual intercourse. Penis pumps are useful in erectile dysfunction. Okay, now, sometimes a penis size is small, need to go for surgery of penis enlargement, PEMUNA surgery. What was happened in this surgery? A silicone insert under penis, skin penis by white three size of making penis size, size large size, extra large or extra extra large making by this surgery. What we do, corpus cavernosum, there is having two cylindrical, and corpus spongiosum. So guys, there is a implantation of silicon artificial which increases the size and which helps in erection of penis. So hope till here it's clear for you, and I will give you one more details about this erectile dysfunction. In this erectile dysfunction, sometimes what happens when a young partner, psychogenic we are going to discuss here, a young partner having an intercourse with a female partner, and this time he can't able to get erection during time or hardness of a penis during intercourse. So what was happen when he perform again attempt intercourse after 3 days, he is shy, afraid and having anxiety that time. He is not thinking about the pleasure, he is thinking about the past bad experience. So again he get erectile dysfunction symptoms, no erection, same. And this anxiety make him worse. So it's need to treat by consultation. So this is psychogenic. So hope guys till here it's clear for you, erectile dysfunction. This is a very very high yield topic, and every human being, at least 75% of young males gone through this problem in their lifetime. So experiencing this problem, but sometimes it's recover automatically by its own. So finally I want to say thank you, and if you like this video, put like on it, and if you have any comments and suggestion you can ask me, and if you are going to suffering from this problem you can contact me for your treatment and consultation. Thank you, good day and goodbye. That's all for today.